my name is Ashley Scheer. I'm the founder and CEO of Scheer Love Fund. Today we're going to do a 10-minute meditation from the beautiful setting of Cabo San Lucas for incarcerated women. And this meditation is geared towards some of the anxiety involved in trying to take on the challenge of learning a new vocation and in taking an exam. And this meditation can also be helpful to anybody taking an exam. Sometimes we prepare, but actually just having to pick up the pen and put it to paper creates a whole host of worries. And sometimes the harder we try to achieve something, the more overwhelming it feels to achieve it, the more inaccessible the answer seems to be. When we're stressed, it's harder to think clearly, and it's harder to access the parts of your brain with the memories. So sometimes we panic, and then we stop breathing, and when we stop breathing, our mind freezes up, and so we can't draw out that information. This makes it harder to remember the right answers for a test. Whether we get nervous before or after or during the test, using meditation or reminding yourself to connect your breath and be in the moment can help you overcome that obstacle to be the best version of yourself, to use tests as an opportunity to show what you do know and not get caught up into what you might not know. So this is important for incarcerated women because education is a pathway to achievement. And sometimes tests are a part of that. So now let's start with the meditation component. Let's take a few breaths together. Can breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth, or you can breathe in whatever way is comfortable to you. You can listen to the sounds of the ocean behind me as a way to create a breath pattern, or you can breathe in your own natural rhythm. As you breathe, try to sort of sink into the space, maybe wiggle around a little bit, and just try to create a sense of stillness. Try to have your spine long. So from the tip of your tailbone to the crown of your head, you want to have a long spine. You can do this as a walking meditation, pairing your footsteps through your breath, or seated down, or even crisscross applesauce, or even lying down. To help you relax, you can use the technique of a body scan meditation, which we did earlier, which is, and you can do this at your own pace because these meditations are limited to 10 minutes. But you can pause and elongate the meditation by connecting your breath mentally with each part of your body. So you can start at your feet and inhale and exhale. And as you exhale, imagine your toes just relaxing. And then you can work your way up to the ball of your foot. Inhale and exhale. And imagine with each inhale and exhale that you're softening that ball of your foot. And you can make this body scan as slow and as long as you need. You can think about relaxing just your right ball of your foot and softening it. And relaxing your left ball of your foot and softening it. From your calves, to your knees, to your thighs, to your sit bones, to your belly, to your chest area, your heart, shoulders, your fingertips, arms and elbows, shoulders, neck, throat, chin, jaw, eyes, your brow and forehead, all the way to the top of your head, the crown of your head, and then you can imagine breathing and just letting your whole body melt as if it were soft wax. So feel free to pause this meditation and do what it takes to feel in a relaxed state. When you're ready, let us resume with creating a meditation that will help should you need to take an exam. Picture the area where the test may take, where you may take the test. Maybe it is in a custodial facility library. Imagine sitting there with the paper in front of you. And notice how your body feels. Take a few deeper breaths. Imagine you could breathe out some of the tension and stress. Inhale and exhale some of that tension and stress. Picture yourself taking the test with ease and focus. From time to time, I may be silent, and that's an opportunity for you to internalize this meditation and really make it your own. You're imagining just sitting down with a pen and paper in hand, and just taking that test with ease. What would it be like if you felt confident that you knew the answers? What would that feel like? Imagine you can breathe in calm and focus and breathe out any nerves or worries. Imagining that you can breathe in calm and focus and breathe out any nerves or worries. Continue to breathe in this way. You can pause this meditation and focus on breathing out, exhaling nerves and worries for as long as you like. Remember that you have these tools whenever you need them. If the nervousness starts to feel overwhelming, you can give it a name, maybe even a silly name. When the nervousness comes and you feel like it's unbearable, maybe call it Pink Fluffy Unicorn. Like, oh, Pink Fluffy Unicorn, you're back again? Oh, those are some big feelings you're putting on me. By giving the rush of feelings a name, sometimes you can, make it, and sometimes by giving it a silly name, like Pink Fluffy Unicorn, you can reduce the impact it has on you because it just seems too ridiculous to take seriously. Another tactic is remembering that feelings, like ocean waves, come and go, and that nothing is permanent, not the good or the bad. So so that the feelings will pass. And remembering that you are not your feelings, that feelings can happen to you. And you can take note of them, and you can choose whether to react or not to them. We encourage response over react. A response is being deliberate in your actions, staying in control. A reaction is more impulsive. And you can remember that you have all of these tools at your disposal, and that you can use what you need when you need it to become the best version of yourself. Namaste.